How great is it when all of your students are engaged in contributing their own unique answers to all of your questions? Let me show you guys how to get this done right in your PowerPoint presentations. Hi everyone, it's Sarah from EdTech. If you're new here, welcome to our channel. Go ahead and subscribe so that you can stay updated on different tech tips for your online classroom. After watching this video today, you guys are going to be able to spice up your online lessons using a short answer question in PowerPoint with ClassPoint. Plus, at the end of this video, I will share another engaging way for you to use this question type during your class. So, let's get started on transforming your lessons. During my PowerPoint presentations, I do like to mix up the kind of questions that I ask my students. Multiple choice questions are nice. However, to add a little bit more interactivity and engagement with my students, I've created two slides here with more open-ended questions instead. So instead of just asking these questions out loud and then picking on a few students to respond, I'm going to use a short answer question from ClassPoint. This allows me to receive responses from every single one of my students. So to do this in our presentation, we just need to go to the EdTech ClassPoint tab and add in a short answer question button. The button will appear on the slide and you can move it to the correct position. And that is all the setup we need so we can just begin our presentation from here. During your presentation, you will see a class code in the top corner. I also have 20 students joined here. So for students to join your class, they can go to classpoint.app and use this class code to join. Or they can scan the QR code that is in the My Class dialog when you click on that class code. When all of your students have joined and you're ready to begin the question, you can just click the short answer button on your slide. Now the question is open for students to begin submitting their responses. To hide the responses from view so that students aren't influenced by each other's responses, we can click on the little eye down here to hide them from the view. This way, students can use their own creativity to answer the question. We can also minimize this window so that you can see the full question slide. The button is yellow and shows you the number of students who have submitted and the timer. So we can click back into this button and check out the live status view. So this live status shows which students have submitted and which students are still pending. So you can help out these students if they have any questions, and it is just another accountability tool to make sure that all of your students are responding to the questions. I love being able to have this interactivity right in my PowerPoint presentations. There's no reason for me to ever leave my presentation to engage my students. When all of your students have submitted, you can close the submission. Then you'll see a view of all the student responses. You can scroll through and like any that really stand out to you. Then we can filter this view by showing only those liked answers. If we click on a specific answer, it will show it a little bit bigger in the light box view. Then I can specifically ask Rebecca to explain in a little bit more detail her response. You can also randomly choose students to explain an answer with our pick a name feature. So you can find out more information on this feature that's linked in the description below. To save these results and analyze them after class, you can click Save for Review. Then you'll see that the question button has been turned green on your slide. And when you click back into it, the same view will appear. To insert a slide of these responses into your presentation, we can click Insert the results as a slide. And now all of these results are embedded right into your PowerPoint presentation. When we go back out into our edit mode, you can also view these responses from the side question panel. And that is how you guys can use the short answer button to engage your students during your online classes. Plus, now let's go through one more additional way of using this question button, but for group activities. The short answer question button can be used in a whole new way when you're doing group activities. Student collaboration is so important, but when you're online teaching, it can be a little bit more difficult. ClassPoint can help you ease this transition. So to add the question button for a group activity, we will do it in the same way. So we'll go to the next slide and add in the short answer button. But this time I'm going to add in a timer. So under the play options, we can close the submission after 5 minutes. This will give my students enough time to discuss and collaborate with one another before finalizing their group response. So when we go into our presentation mode, we can click on the button and students can go off into their breakout rooms. When they have discussed and finalized their answer, they can submit their response. If the timer is running out and not all the groups have submitted yet, you can always add more time. If all the students have submitted their answers and the timer is still going, you can close the submissions early. Then you'll see a full view of all of the group responses. We can insert every single one of these responses as their own slide. This will allow us to annotate right on screen. You can highlight any important parts of their responses or take some extra notes right on your screen. Then when we go into our edit mode, you'll see that the annotations along with the student responses have saved as slides embedded into your presentation. Now you guys know two different ways to use the short answer question in PowerPoint with ClassPoint. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, you can give us a thumbs up and let us know in the comments below how you guys engage your students when online teaching.